Welcome to the Chemistry Live channel. Today we are discuss about the synthesis of benzimidazole. So here the structure is benzimidazole is very unique. The one portion is benzene and the another portion is imidazole ring. So that is called benzimidazole. So let's see what is the background of benzimidazole and what is the uses of benzimidazole. So in the background, it's like a heterocyclic aromatic organic compound. As I told you before, it's benzene and imidazole ring. Benzimidazole is heterocyclic. Benzimidazole is heterocyclic aromatic organic compound. Having a fusion of benzene and imidazole ring, it is colorless solid. It is used as anti-tumor, antifungal, antiparasitic, analgesic, antiviral, and antihistamine drug. So it is multi-purpose drug we can use as a different kind of disease. It's also used as cardiovascular disease, neurological disease, endocrinology disease, and ophthalmology disease. It is several dyes. It's also used as several dyes to be prepared. So we can say this benzimidazole as used as medicinal drug as well dye industry. So it is very common feature. Now, in the principle, the synthesis, or we can say the retrosynthesis of benzimidazole shows here when these two groups are detached, we will got orthophenylendiamine and formic acid. So the synthesis of benzimidazole affected by the simple heating of the orthophenylendiamine and the formic acid together. So here the requirement is orthophenylendiamine, formic acid 90% and sodium hydroxide solution 10%. So what is about the mole ratio? Here its given mole ratio is 1.735. Now we can calculate the taken mole ratio. So here we can mark A, B, C, it is a D, it is a E, it is a F, it is a G, and it is a H. So our aim is to get H. But how we can get this H? It is very important as well. So first we get a C. C is equal to weight by molecular weight. So is equal to 5 divided by 210.23 and we will get 0.023 moles. When we multiply this 0.023 moles with the mole ratio of formic acid is 0.0735, then we will get 0.017 is moles of formic acid. The moles of formic acid gives the weight of formic acid after the multiplication with the molecular weight. So when the molecular weight is multiplied with the moles of the formic acid, we will get the gram weight of the formic acid. That is 1.04 gram. When we divide with the density 1.220, we will get 0.86 ml. So 0.86 ml formic acid required to prepare benzimidazole from 5 gram of diphenylamine. Now we will switch to the reactions. It is very simple reaction scheme. Orthophenylendiamine react with formic acid. In presence of NaOH, we will get the intermediate compound. And after removal of water molecule, we will get benzimidazole with 118.14 gram per mole molecular weight. In the mechanism section, let's see how it's prepared. So the nitrogen has lone pair and the formic acid have a carbonyl carbon. The carbonic carbon possesses an inductive effect. So here I minus, so this is the first step. Then the lone pair attack to the carbon, the second step. The inductive effect on oxygen, the excess charge of oxygen returned back to the bond, it is the third step. And at the end, it's the removal of OH, so it's fourth step. After that whole step, we will get OH minus removed and there is 2NH2 and positive charge here. So the positive charge, the bond is shifted towards here and the hydrogen is removed. So here removal of hydrogen ion is possible. After the removal of hydrogen ion, here the C double bond O again possesses the inductive effect and the lone pair of another nitrogen atom is attached to the carbon and we will get this kind of intermediate compound. That intermediate compound has a positive charge for the nitrogen atom. So again, it takes an electron from bond and removal of hydrogen is possible. But that hydrogen is directly attached to the O minus and it got OH. So therefore, the lone pair of electron transfer to the bond and then the removal of OH minus is possible and we will get our final compound benzimidazole. So we will switch to the procedure. Procedure is so simple. First, we will take round bottom flask. In this round bottom flask, We will put a stirrer. We add in that round bottom flask 27 gram of orthophenylene diamine compound, 17.5 gram of or 16 ml formic acid. Heat that round bottom flask at 100 degree temperature for 2 hours. After the completion of 2 hours, cool it and add 10% NaOH solution to that, to the round bottom flask. Mix well, stir well the solution. When you stir well the mixture, the litmus paper becomes alkaline. Filter off the crude, wash with ice cold water, and at the end wash with 25 ml of cold water. In the crystallization process, boil the water 400 ml, add 2 gram of carbon or animal charcoal, then the crude compound, digest it for 15 minutes, then filter it, put it in 10 degree centigrade temperature. So we'll get benzene mineral crystal immediately. Wash with 25 ml cold water and dry it 100 degree temperature. We'll get 25 gram compound. So next the calculation. The calculation we have molecular formula of starting and the product, molecular weight of starting and the product. So we can say if we have 108 gram per mole orthophenylene diamine, we will get 118.14 gram per mole benzimidazole. So what about 5 gram? So we did the calculation and we get result B. The practical yield is 3.9 gram. So to find out percentage yield, we have to do 3.9 divided by V into 100. So we will get percentage yield. And the next section is characterization section, which is deal with the characterization of IR, NMR and mass. So benzimidazole, that peak, if we smoothening it more, it will be like complete parabolic shape. So it is 3000, we can say, or 2700 centimeter inverse. Here also one peak is possible, that is about 1750 centimeter inverse. We have to identify from that one the peak which is belonging from for NH and the peak which is belonging for N double bond C, stretching and vibration frequencies. So next we will switch to that mass spectrum. The molecular weight of benzimidazole is about 118. So here we get the peak 118. So it is M plus peak, and the another peak here we get is 119. So it is M plus 1 peak. So from that we can conclude that yes, our compound is prepared from the mass spectrum. And the last but not least, it is very important in the case of the either the compound synthesis or not. So let's see first. First we'll get the peak at 8.8, it's 1H for 1H and singlet due to the neighboring effect of that hydrogen only. So we have only singlet because there is no effect on that neighbor. So here the 1H of that peak we will get. Another we'll get at 7.17, here doublet. Because of that hydrogen is take the environment is this hydrogen and another is that, it will be just try to move and we get doublet. If we not consider it too much distance, so we will cancel it out. For the here, both for the same. For the here, we will say we will get also doublet. And for the particular NH, here we will get only singlet with a low intensity at 5 ppm. So that is confirmed that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hydrogen atom and or the 6 proton. That 6 proton are easily shown in a 1H NMR. And that is confirmed that our compound is synthesized. Result table. So in result table, you have to write name. till the percentage yield what we get from the practical analysis. The IR mass and NMR's technique shows us the presence of NH and C double bond N or N double bond C group. The percentage yield we will get here, you have to write down here. That is some references which I use the information. And thank you for watching. Please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get more notification soon.